good morning, good afternoon, good night, wherever you're watching this from. Welcome to Assem Live. This is Assem Sports. Happy Monday, bright, beautiful Monday, cold winter Monday. This is the time and season where true champions are made. And Liverpool jogging club said, no Salah, no problem. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. The games over the weekend has further put in a, should I say, a different twist as to who is going to finish top four, who will win the coveted Premier League trophy. Liverpool have proven that they can carry on without their Egyptian magician Mo Salah, who has left to the AFCON tournament. We're going to touch on the AFCON games, the tournament of the moment is what I call it. The African Soccer Cup of Nations is living up to its billing. Entertaining, we're going to touch about that. But the Premier League, the upper echelon, the creme de la creme, returned this weekend with bangers upon bangers. It was a goals galore. Arsenal, Liverpool contending to challenge Manchester City all came up with wonderful wins. Arsenal were able to beat Crystal Palace 5-0. The performance was better than their performances of recent, but if you were a true Arsenal fan, you would know that Crystal Palace defensively were quite poor, and Arsenal still have a goal scoring problem. Like, a defender got two goals. Gabriel was the one. If you have a team and the defenders are getting the goals, it is okay, but you need to understand that we have strikers for a reason. Arsenal beat Crystal Palace 5-0. Ivan Toney returned. The legendary Ivan Toney is still doing what Ivan Toney does. After 8 months serving the ban, you could tell Ivan Toney did not skip a beat, did not miss a step, came in getting the goal, leading Brentford as the captain 3-2 against Nottingham Forest. Okay, Sheffield United play. It was a goals galore. I mean, entertaining games all through the weekend. Most people were of the view that the AFCON and the Asian tournament has taken some talent out of the Premier League, and it might affect the entertainment and just the flashy nature of the games. The Premier League is still surging on. Entertaining 2-2 draw between Sheffield United and West Ham. That game was a cracker, ended in the dying minute. Both teams playing with 10 men, two red cards were shown. They left it all on the field. 2-2 draw. Liverpool were able to beat Bournemouth 4-0 without Mo Salah, Darwin Nunes, and Diego Jota. Jogging club has found a way to get wins in the second half. It is becoming a part of their DNA, Liverpool this season, where it's almost like he experiments in the first half to find where the pitfalls are and changes it in the second half. He played Darwin Nunes on the left, which was quite surprising to me, because I would play Darwin Nunes right through the middle and play Jota and what's his like the other player, Luis Diaz, like on the right, and alternate Luis Diaz and Diego Jota, and leave Darwin in the middle. He did that in the second half, and if you watch the game, that's when they started getting the goals. Liverpool have proven that they are the most likely, if you ask me, the most likely team to give Man City a run for their money. I always say that the team with the most depth of squad goes the farthest. And Liverpool with major key players missing, even though Virgil van Dijk, I must say, when Virgil van Dijk is playing well and he's on his toes, Liverpool is a whole different team. And the midfield combination, like the defensive between Virgil van Dijk and Konate, I mean, it was exceptionally splendid, even though they were playing against Bournemouth. No disrespect to Bournemouth, one would say. So yes, Liverpool have a lot of young kids in the squad who can come on like the game against Bournemouth and deliver the results. I don't see the same for Arsenal, who are riddled with injuries but also lacking a clinical goal scorer. So we are here to find out who. I feel Liverpool is still sitting on top. They never walk alone. They beat Bournemouth 4-0, and today the battle for the middle. Other teams are vying for the top four spots. Other teams are also confident in their ability to play on the Europa level. They don't know that even similar to Newcastle, they haven't really reached the Champions League level yet. Brighton, a team who's currently playing in Europe for the first time in a long time, is playing against Wolves, who have always been a really well-oiled team, but the ability to score goals has always been a problem. They have to provide results. Brighton also is playing well under De Zerbi. So these are the games going on today in the Premier League. Happy Monday. Brighton is playing Wolves. Liverpool is still sitting on top of the Premier League as we speak now. Will they be able to sustain and maintain the pressure from Manchester United is definitely not doing well this season. Chelsea and is playing in the Carabao Cup tomorrow. We're going to touch on those games as well. But like I said, the AFCON is the tournament of the moment, and games are going on today where Nigeria is currently beat Guinea-Bissau 1-0. Equatorial Guinea beat Ivory Coast, the host nation. It's been a terrible tournament for the host nation. Things are not looking good. Equatorial Guinea beat them 4-0. Today, later on in the day, Ghana Black Stars is playing against Mozambique. The group which has Egypt and Ghana has become the most talked about group, where Egypt and Cape Verde is also playing today. Between Cape Verde and Egypt and Ghana and Mozambique, who is going to qualify? Cape Verde is already through. The second and third spot is up for grabs. This is going to be the talked about game in the AFCON. Thank you for tuning in to Assem Sports. Happy Monday. Have a wonderful week. Like you already know, the Forecast 1.0. New ASCM music collection available on all platforms. Click the link in the bio. This has been Assem Sports. Brother Jonah coming soon.